Besides, there is whole of some other pro apoptotic factors. These are the BAT, BATS and BAT and the P53. And the apoptosis inhibitors, these are BCL2, BCLX. In the cancer cell, the function of the apoptosis is inhibited due to the mutations in the above genes, which regulates the apoptosis in the normal cell. The BCL2 gene is seen in normal lymphocytes, but its mutant form with the characteristic translocation 1418 and 3221 was first described in B cell lymphomas and has the name BCL. It is also seen in the breast, thyroid, and the prostate carcinomas. The mutation in the BCL2 gene removes the apoptosis inhibitory control on the cancer cells, and they will causing the cells undergoing the mitosis, contributing to tumor growth. Besides the MYC oncogenes and the P53 tumor suppressor genes are also connected to apoptosis. The MYC allows the cell growth by BCL2 inhibits the cell death. So the MYC and the BCL2 together allow the cell proliferation. Normally the P53 activates the para-apoptotic gene BATS, but mutated P53. When absence of P53, it will reduce the apoptotic activity and causing the cell proliferation in a neoplastic lesion. The CD95 receptors are depleted in the hepatocellular carcinomas and as the tumor cells escape the apoptosis. The next hallmark of the gene for producing the neoplasm is the avoiding the cellular aging, and it will function by the telomerase and the telomerase activity in the neoplastic cell to suppress. After the each mitosis or the cell doubling, there is a progressive shortening of the telomeres, which are the terminal tips of the chromosome. So there is a loss of a arm of a gene. The telomerase is the RNA enzyme that helps in repair of such damage to the DNA and maintains the normal telomere length in successive cell divisions. After the repetitive mitosis for a maximum of 60 to 70 times, the telomeres are lost in normal cells and the cells cease to undergo mitosis. So when there is a multiple repetitive division of a telomere, it will be shortened in a time. The telomerase is active in normal stem cells but not in the normal somatic cells. The cancer cells in the most of the malignancies having a markedly upregulated telomerase enzyme, and hence the telomere length is maintained. The cancer cells avoid the aging by mitosis, does not slow down or ceases, thereby the immortalizing the cell cancer cell. So it is one of the important causes of immortalizing of the cell or a conversion of the malignancy of a neoplastic cell. The fifth hallmark is continued perfusion of the cancers by tumor angiogenesis. The new vascularization not only supplies the tumor with oxygen and nutrition, but the newly formed endothelial cells also elaborate a few growth factors for progression of the primary as well as the metastatic cancer. The factors: promoters of the tumor angiogenesis include the most important vascular endothelial growth factor. They are released from genes in the parenchymal tumor cells and the basic fibroblast growth factors. The anti-angiogenic factors inhibiting the angiogenesis includes thrombospondin 1. It is also produced by the tumor cells themselves. The angiostatin, endostatin, and the vasculostatins, mutated form of the P53 gene in both alleles in various cancers, results in removal of the anti-angiogenic role of thrombospondin 1. So they are favoring the continued angiogenesis in a neoplastic lesion. Sixth is the invasion and the distant metastasis or the cancer dissemination. One of the most important characteristics of the cancer is invasiveness and the metastasis. The mechanism we have already studied in details previously. The seventh one is the DNA damage and the repair system, the mutated genes and the cancers. The normal cells during the complex mitosis suffers from minor damage to the DNA, which is detected and repaired before mitosis is completed, so that integrity of the genome is maintained. The P53 gene is responsible for the detection and repair of the DNA damage. If the system of the DNA repair is defective, as happens in some of the inherited mutations, these are the by the mutator genes, the defect in the unrepaired DNA is passed to the next progeny of the cells and causes the cancer. So here are some examples of the inherited mutation and producing the different types of the cancer, by which these are the hereditary non-polyposis colonic cancer, the Lynch syndrome, the ataxia telangiectasia, xeroderma pigmentosum, Lynch syndrome, hereditary breast cancer. The H1, the cancer progression and the heterogeneity by the clonal aggressiveness. With the passage of the time, the cancer becomes more aggressive. This is termed as the tumor progression. The clinical parameters of the cancer progression are the increasing size of the tumor, higher histologic grade, areas of the tumor necrosis, invasiveness, and the distant metastasis. With passage of the time, the cancer cells acquire more and more heterogeneity by dividing the multiple types of the genes. The mean of the cancer cells remain monoclonal in origin. They acquire more and more mutation, which in turn reduces the multiple mutated subpopulation of more aggressive clones of the cancer cells. This is heterogeneous cells. In the growth, which have tendency to invade metastasis and are refractory to the hormonal influences, some of these mutations in fact may kill the tumor cells as well as, but some are capable to grow in further events. Next is the cancer sequential multi-step molecular phenomena or multi-step story. It needs to be appreciated that the cancer occurs several sequential states of the abnormalities in the target cells by the initiation, promotion, and the
motivation
Similarly, the multi-states are involved at the genetic level by the self-proliferation of the cancer cells is activated. So, here the three points are activation caused by the activation of the growth promoter, by the loss of the growth suppressor, activation of the intrinsic apoptosis mechanism, and escape in the cellular agent. So all these three factors will for the cells to develop a malignant lesion. A classic example of this sequential genetic abnormality cancer is adenoma carcinoma. Here the secret is the development of the colorectal carcinoma. This is the molecular model for the evolution of the colorectal cancer to the adenoma carcinoma sequence, by which we will know about the different types of stages. Here, comparisons. First is the morphological appearance and the molecular changes that will be developing to the neoplastic cell. The normal epithelial cells forming a hyperproliferative epithelium. At the level of the molecular changes, here the loss of the mutation of APC locus or the chromosome. These on the chromosome. The pathological appearance of a cell and the molecular changes will be consistently distinct from the each stage, from the normal to malignant cells. The molecular changes are also the different types of stages. In the the tank microRNAs in non-coding single stranded RNA molecules with a length of 22 only. Normally, miRNAs functions as the post translational gene regulators of the they are differentiation and the survival of the cell. MicroRNAs have been identified. The microRNAs have an oncogenic role in initiation and the progression of the cancer. They are abbreviated as a oncomeres. In the combination with other tumor-associated genes, oncomeres can perform a various functions as a tumor suppressor or as a tumor promoter and as a pro-apoptotic genes. Here, some tumor suppressor genes and the associated family syndromes and their cancers by the cancer hallmarks which we have discussed. The inhibitors of the microgenic signaling pathways. The genes APC by the proteins adenomatous polyposis coli protein they will function as an inhibitor of the WBM signaling pathways and producing the familial colony polyps and the carcinomas. In these sporadic cases, they will produce the carcinoma for stomach, colon, pancreas, and melanomas. The second gene is NF1. The protein which will involve for the function is neurofibromin 1. It will function by the inhibition of the RAS or MAPK signaling pathway. The familial syndromes produced by NF1 gene are the neurofibromatosis type 1. These are also called as the neurofibromas and the malignant peripheral nerve sheath tumors. In sporadic cancer, NF1 gene producing the neuroblastoma, juvenile myeloid leukemias. The NF2 gene by the Merlin protein functions as a cytoskeleton stability and hippocampal signaling. By the loss of this gene, they will produce the neurofibromatosis type 2, atopic schwannomas, and the meningiomas. In sporadic cancer, they will produce the schwannoma and meningiomas. The PTCH gene by FAST, they will function by inhibition of the. They will produce the Gorlin syndrome. Will include the basal cell carcinoma. Severe benign. In the sporadic cancer, the basal cell carcinoma and the medulloblastoma. The PTEN gene will produce phosphatase and the tansin homologous protein. This will be inhibitors of the PI3K or the AKT signaling pathways and producing the Cowden syndrome, the variety of the benign skin, GI and the CNS growths, rays, endometrial and the thyrocarcinoma. In the sporadic cancers, they will produce the diverse cancers, particularly into the carcinomas and the lymphoid tumors. The SMAD2 and SMAD4, producing the SMAD2 and 4 proteins, they will function by a component of the TGF-beta signaling pathway, repressors of the FYC and CDK4 expression. They will inducers of the CDK inhibitor expressions. The familial syndromes, producing the juvenile polyposis. In sporadic cancer, they will frequently mutate along with the other components of the TGF-beta signaling pathways, the colonic and the pancreatic carcinomas. The second group includes the inhibitors of the cell cycle progression. It will include hepatitis C, cardi, gene, and the CDK. The RB gene by the protein retinoblastoma functions as an inhibitor of the G1 to S transition during the cell cycle progression, and they will produce in the familial retinoblastoma syndrome. It will include the retinoblastoma, osteosarcoma, and the sarcomas. In sporadic cases, they will produce in the retinoblastoma, osteosarcomas, carcinomas, or the of the breast. The colonic lung cancers also. The CDKN2A by P16, INK4A, and P14 ARF protein, they function. The P16 is a negative regulator of the cyclin dependent kinases, and the P14 is the indirect activator of P53 gene. They will produce in the familial melanomas and sporadic cancers by the pancreatic sporadic cancer, they will producing the pancreatic, breast, and the esophageal carcinomas, melanomas, and the certain types of the leukemias. Another group is the inhibitors of the pro-growth programs of the metabolism and the angiogenesis. It includes the VHL genes by the protein von Hippel-Lindau or VHL. They function by inhibition of the hypoxia-induced transcription factor, which is activated at IF1 alpha. They will produce the von Hippel-Lindau syndrome. It includes the cerebellar hemangioblastoma, retinal angiomas, renal cell carcinoma. In sporadic cancer, they will cause the renal cell carcinoma. The next gene is STK11. The protein is liver kinase B1 or LKB1 or STK11. They will function as activator of the AMPK family of the kinases. They will suppress the cell growth when the cell nutrition and the energy levels are low. And they will produce the Peutz Jeghers syndrome, GI polyps, GI cancer, pancreatic carcinomas, and the carcinomas, other carcinomas. Sporadically, they will produce the diverse carcinomas, 5 to 20% of the cases, depending on the type of a cancer. The SDHB and SDHD genes produce the succinate dehydrogenase complex, subunits B and E. They function by TCSI family, pheochromocytomas and the paragangliomas, sporadic cases. Next group is inhibitors of the invasion and the metastasis. The gene includes CDH1. The protein is ecatherin. They will function by the cell adhesion, inhibition of the cell mortality. They will produce the familial gastric cancers. Sporadically, they will produce the gastric carcinoma, lobular breast carcinoma. Next one is the enablers of the genomic stability. The gene includes T53 by the protein P53 protein. The cell cycle arrest and the apoptosis in response to DNA damage will be occur, and it will lead to lymphoma syndrome. In sporadic cases, most of the human cancers are caused by the T53 gene. Another group is DNA repair factors. It includes BRCA1, BRCA2. The proteins, breast cancer 1 and breast cancer 2 or BRCA1-2, they will function by the repair of the double-stranded breaks in the DNA. The familial syndrome, producing the familial breast and the ovarian carcinomas, the carcinomas of the male breast, and the chronic lymphocytic leukemia by the BRCA2 gene. Sporadic cancers are rarely occurred by the BRCA1 and BRCA2 genes. The second one gene is MSH2, MLH1, MSH6. They will produce in the protein MSH1, MLH1. And MSH6 proteins, and they will function by DNA mismatch repair. The familial syndromes are produced by these genes are hereditary non-polyposis colon carcinomas. In sporadic cancers, they will produce the colonic and the endometrial carcinomas. Some of the genes having unknown mechanism, these are the WT1 and MAN1 genes. The WT1 gene having a Wilms tumor 1 protein and functions by a transcriptional factor and produce the familial cell being produced by the WT1 gene. MAN1 having a protein manine It also functions as transcription factor. The familial syndromes which will be producing the tumor are the multiple endocrine neoplasia 1 or MAN 1. It includes the pituitary, parathyroid, and the pancreatic endocrine tumors. So these are the different types of the genes which will be causing the different types of the tumor. Here the flow chart, which will be simplifies the molecular basis of the cancer, which we have understand throughout the lecture. So here the acquired or the environmental DNA damaging agents like the chemical radiation or the viral oncogenes, they will producing the normal cells to damage DNA or the genome. If the DNA or the genome is successfully repaired, it will be reversed to the normal cells. If it is not reversed, or DNA damage will be persist, or failure of the DNA repair will occur by the inherited mutation in genes affecting the DNA repair or the genes affecting the cell growth or apoptosis. They both causing the mutation in the genomes of the somatic cells. That genetically altered somatic cells, by the activation of the growth promoting oncogenes or the inactivation of the tumor suppressor genes, forming a unregulated cell proliferation. By the alteration in the genes that regulate the apoptosis, they will also be causing the decreased apoptosis of a normal completion of the cell cycle. So both the unregulated cell proliferation and decreased apoptosis are causing the clonal expansion of a tissue by the cell proliferation. The clonal expansion by the aggravation of the angiogenesis, escape from the immunity and the additional mutations, they will form in a tumor progression. These tumor progression cells or the tissue further form a malignant neoplasm, and the neoplasm will causing an invasion and metastasis to the different sites. Now, the second one is the chemical carcinogens. The chemical carcinogens, in 1975, a London surgeon, Sir Percival Pott, correctly attributed the scrotal skin cancer in the chimney sweeps to chronic exposure to soot and the coal tar as a possible carcinogenic agent, and the possibility of the other occupational cancers in the induced ones. First successful experiment induction of the cancer was produced by the two workers. These are the Yamagiwa and the Ishikawa in 1914 in the rabbit skin by the repeatedly painting with coal tar. The steps involved in the chemical carcinogenesis are: the induction occurs after a delay by weeks to months in experimental animals and often several years in a man. The dose and the mode of the administration of factors, the individual susceptibility and various predisposing factors, the basic mechanism of a chemical carcinogenesis is by the mutation in the proto-oncogenes and the anti-oncogenes. The phenomena of the cellular transformation involving the three sequential stages in the chemical carcinogenesis are: the initiation, then promotion and the progression. So all the three stages will lead to a carcinogen, to producing a carcinogenesis by a chemical agent or a different type of chemical substances. So what is initiation of the chemical carcinogenesis? It is induced by the initiator chemical carcinogens. The changes produced by the single dose of an agent for a short time. So the larger dose for the longer time is more effective. Changes induces are sudden, irreversible, and the permanent. The chemical carcinogens grouped into two categories. First, direct acting carcinogens. These are the chemical substances, including the alkylating agents, acylating agents, which can induce the cellular transformation without undergoing any prior metabolic activation. So, the carcinogens doesn't require to metabolic activation. Second is indirect acting carcinogens or the procarcinogens. These requires metabolic conversion within the body so as to become a ultimate, and they will produce in the carcinogen and having a carcinogenicity in the after the metabolic conversion. This table showing the different types of the direct and indirect acting carcinogens and the tumors produced by them. The direct acting carcinogens, including the alkylating agents, these are the anti-cancer drugs. It may be the cyclophosphamide, clonazepam, busulfan, nesosulfan, nitrosourea, beta propiolactones and epoxides. And the alkylating agents, these are the acetyl imidazole, dimethyl carbamyl chlorides. They producing the lymphomas, acute myeloid leukemias, and the bladder carcinomas in the humans. The indirect acting carcinogens or the procarcinogens includes the polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbons. It includes they are used in the tobaccos, smoke, fossil fuels, food, tar, mineral oils, smoked animals, foods, industrial and the atmospheric pollutants. And anthracenes includes the benzene, dibenzo or the dimethyl benzene, alkylating agents, and the benzopyrenes, methyl prolanthrenes. They are all causing the lung cancer, skin cancer, and the cancer of the upper aerodigestive tract. The aromatic amines and azo dyes, beta naphthalamine, benzidine, azo dyes, they will causing the bladder carcinomas and the hepatocellular carcinomas by the azo dyes. They are used in the butter to yellowing or coloration of the adulteration of the butters and the scarlet threads. Naturally occurring products are aflatoxin B1, actinomycin D, mitomycin C, saffron, and the betel nuts. They will cause in the hepatocellular carcinoma. Some of the miscellaneous indirect acting carcinogens are nitrosamines and the nitrosamides. They will produce in the gastric carcinomas. Vinyl chloride monomers, they form in the angiosarcomas of the liver. Asbestos, they will cause in bronchogenic carcinoma, mesotheliomas. Arsenic compounds, they will produce in the cancer skin, cancers in skin and lungs. The metals, nickel, lead, cobalt, and cadmium, causing the lung cancers. Insecticides, fungicides, having the aldrin, dieldrin, and the cordants, and the saccharin and the cyclomates producing the cancer in the experiment animals. The metabolic activation, the majority of the carcinogens are indirect acting or the pro-carcinogens requiring the metabolic activation. The direct acting carcinogens not require the activation. Indirect acting carcinogens activated in the liver by monooxygenase of the cytochrome E450 system in endoplasmic reticulum. The pro-carcinogens may be detoxified and rendered inactive metabolically. In fact, following two requirements determine the carcinogenic potency of the chemicals. These are, first, the balance between the activation and the inactivation reaction of the carcinogenic chemicals. Second is genes that code for the cytochrome P450 dependent enzymes involved in the metabolic activation. Besides these two, additional factors such as the age, sex, and the nutritional status of the host also plays some role in determining the response of the individual to chemical carcinogens. The reactive electrophiles, while direct acting carcinogens are intrinsically electrophilic, the indirect acting substances become the electron deficient after the metabolic activation. They become the reactive electrophiles following this step. Both types of the chemical carcinogens behaves alike, and their reactive electrophiles binds to electron-rich proteins of other molecules of the cell, such as DNA, RNA, and other proteins. The target molecules, the primary target of the neutrophils. Neutrophiles is DNA. They will produce the mutagenesis. The changes in the DNA may lead to initiated cell or some form of the cellular enzymes able to repair the damage in DNA. The carcinogenic potential of a chemical is tested in vitro by amylase test for the mutagenesis. Any gene may be targeted molecules in the DNA for the chemical carcinogens. Chemically induced cancers in the experimental animals most frequently affected growth promoter oncogenes is rashi mutation, and anti-oncogene is P53 gene mutation. The next stage, the initiated cell, it is a unrepaired damage. Production in the DNA of the cell becomes permanent and fixed only if the altered cell undergoes at least one cycle proliferation. They will result in transforming the changes to the next progeny of the cells, so the DNA damage becomes permanent and irreversible. Initiated cells are vulnerable to the action of the promoters of the carcinogenesis. They will stimulate for the proliferation. They come from the regeneration of the surviving cells. The dietary factors, hormones, induced hyperplasia, and the viruses are in this category. After the initiation, second stage is the promotion of the carcinogenesis. It is the next sequential stage in the chemical carcinogenesis. The promoters of the carcinogenesis are substances such as the formal esters, phenols, hormones, artificial sweeteners, and the drugs like inhibitors are the promoting agents. They differ from the initiators in the following respects. They do not produce sudden changes. they require the application or the administration is the case may be following the initiated exposure for the sufficient time and in sufficient doses. The changes induces may be reversible. They do not damage the DNA per se and are thus not mutagenic, but instead enhance the effect of the direct carcinogens or pro-carcinogens. The tumor promoters act by further clonal proliferation and expansion of the initiated or the mutated cells and have a reduced requirement of the growth factor, especially after the RAS gene mutation. So the promoters of the genes are different rather than the promoting genes. Their action is different. Next step is progression of the carcinogenesis. The stage when the mutated proliferated cell shows the phenotypic features of the malignancy. The features pertain to morphology, biochemical composition, and the molecular features of the malignancy. The phenotypic features only appear only when the initiated cell starts to proliferate rapidly and in the process acquires more and more mutations. The new progeny of the cells that develops after such repetitive proliferation inherits the genetic and the biochemical characteristics of a malignancy that is altered by the carcinogen. So it is the sequential stages. The direct acting carcinogens and indirect acting carcinogens or the pro-carcinogens. The direct acting carcinogens by no metabolic activity and indirect acting carcinogens by metabolic activation promoting the target cells to come into the different stages of the carcinogenesis. The target cell will damaged by the carcinogens and they will forming a reactive electrophiles and the target molecules, mainly the DNA or the RNAs, they will be permanently damaged by the DNA and this step is initiation. Next stage is promotion, in which the damaged DNA cell will forming a clonal proliferation or expansion of a altered cells. It will be further converted into the mutated cell or the malignant looking cells. These will be further forming a malignant tumor by the progression of these mutated cells.
videos on it. So what I will start doing is I will start downloading all the YouTube videos and post it on my Facebook page as well. I will post it on my Instagram. It's Praveen ET. You can go and follow me on Instagram. But if my YouTube channel gets banned, has some strange strategies in restricting your views. When I post a video, in the first 24 hours, the video will reach 100,000. And then suddenly they will post a restriction on it and they will say, we have to review this. And the video will start showing up on your feeds. Even if you subscribe to me, even if you click the bell button. Many, many people call me and say, Praveen, I clicked on the bell button. I follow you all the time. I even share your videos to everybody. But your videos do not show up when I open YouTube. I don't know why. I would assume that YouTube has decided not to show my videos on your feeds. And you know, in the past, you know, week, 2 weeks, all my videos are being manually reviewed by YouTube. And this is really interesting for me because whenever I send a mail to YouTube, YouTube now tells me, well, we don't have very many employees because of, you know, the coronavirus COVID-19 issue. But yet YouTube has to manually review my videos every time I post a video. And in the meantime, you get the most number of hits in the first 24 hours and 48 hours. And if you decide that my video is objectionable, you just block the views. And after 24 hours, you don't manually review my videos every time I post a video. And in the meantime, you get the most number of hits in the first 24 hours and 48 hours. And if you decide that my video is objectionable, you just block the views. And after 24 hours, you don't show it to my subscribers and I don't get any views. It's really strange what, you know, YouTube is doing. Okay, so this is what I wanted to tell you guys. Normally, I never talk about all these things. I don't consider it as very productive. Okay, I will try to post another video soon, in a couple of days, because I have a lot of good information about sacred geometry and numbers and all that stuff. That video will be coming up. But I don't know if YouTube has banned me tomorrow. Just go to my Facebook or Instagram page or something like that. I also have a Patreon. You can go there as well. And you can find me there. I will post my findings there. Keep in touch. Please do leave a comment if you see this video, because I wonder, what if YouTube bans this video, right? What if YouTube decides not to show this video? So if you're watching this video, just share it with your friends. So at least, you know manually you have shared it to somebody and they can see the video. So this is what is going on. I don't know if you guys should give this video a thumbs up or a thumbs down. But this is an update and I think it's an important update and I don't want you to be in the dark if my channel just vanishes. Okay. I hope it's not my last video. Bye guys. Take care.
Thank you.